guys have known each other forever. You wrote Celebrity Jeopardy together.
We did. Yeah. In the first sketch, coming back from the transitional year, Steve Higgins played, he went out there in a diaper. You remember that, Steve?
Yeah.
And
played F. Lee Bailey. My very first show.
Very first show.
I remember that.
And so they did a review, and they said the show is not good when the best guy on it's the stagehand.
I'll take it as a compliment.
Yeah, you're the one you brought that around, showed it to people.
Exactly.
Like, hey, you see the great review?
I got a T-shirt printed up in a mug.
But you guys, you would hang out all the time. You play games and you do fun things. Like,
yeah, I love Higgins, man. And listen, you know, you've changed the face of television with your games. My goodness. Every time I turn on the TV, there's a new games deal. Patrick Harris, the funnest games, you know. Jane Lynch, she's a lady from Gleef. Game.
Yeah.
You've changed it, even though you have the greatest games of all.
Thank you, yeah.
But me and Higgins, we used to do a game. It was the funnest game in the world, charades.
Yeah, of course, I know charades. Yeah, I've heard of that. Yeah. Pretty famous game, yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm not claiming authorship of charades.
No, okay. Yeah.
I'm saying that Higgins was maybe as close as you could get to Harpo Marx when it came to... When it came to charades, you know?
The most physical of the Marx Brothers.
Yes. And if he came out, if he would come out from his podium where he reigns so...
Supreme,
you know, and
could you do,
and,
Higgins, could you do some charades?
Imparts his witty badinage. Yeah. Oh, here he is.
Higgins, what would you do? So you would do... All right. How's it work?
All right, I'll just do... It could be anything.
You can do anything.
It could be like a...
How's it work, Norm?
We can do things. Yeah, activities.
Yeah, he does something, and then we have to guess what he's doing.
Okay.
It's an activity. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's not. It's more like a mime.
I can play this. Okay, miming.
An activity.
Right. Okay, this is an activity. Hey, whoa, hey.
No, I didn't expect this.
What's going on?
I apologize.
Higgins, you can't do that, man.
I'm rolling dice.
Oh.
Seven.
Oh, well, in all fairness. Oh.
Sorry.
What did you think?
It was really us more than him.
I apologize.
He was doing...
Oh, he was rolling dice.
He was rolling dice.
I'm sorry, I jumped to a conclusion. Do you want to give us another example?
I feel ashamed.
No, could you... Higgins, I'm sorry.
What do you think it was?
No, nothing.
Sorry.
Could you just give us another one, just one more, and then we'll sit. Oh, my. Hey, Higgins, stop.
Ho,
stop that.
This is 11:30. This isn't Seth Meyers.
I'm playing pinball.
What?
Pinball.
Oh, I see.
Oh, he's playing pinball.
Playing pinball.
I didn't know what was going on.
I didn't either, Jimmy. I think the problem is with us. You know, our minds are so corrupt, so diseased, you know, by this new society that we can't accept a man that sees things through a boy's eyes.
Can you give us one last example?
One last chance. You should be giving us one last chance.
One last to redeem your filthy, gutter-filled mind.
Yes. Well, how did you? You don't know what we're thinking.
I think I do.
Oh. All right, here's the last one.
Last one.
And we'll guess what it is. Mm. Hey, what? Hey, you said you used to play this game with him?
I have never seen him do this. I mean, this can only mean one thing. I think everyone knows what this means.
Do it again.
No, this is not...
No, that is filthy.
No, come
on.
I'm making sure the bathwater is right temperature for the baby. My God.
We should talk. I'm sorry, Father. We should talk later.